Sorry.
I know.
Today, I'm gonna show you how to create a basic animation. I'll show you some fun ways to use deformers with basic geometrical shapes inside of Cinema 4D. So for the animation of the cube, I am gonna use the twist deformer. So I'm gonna click on the twist and I'm gonna make it a child of the cube. And now, as you see, it twists perfectly. So we just have to add some keyframes. So I'm gonna go back to zero frame and I'm gonna put the angle to zero to start. And I'm gonna keyframe the zero. So that means that the computer now remembers that our first degree of angle for twisting the cube is gonna be zero. Then I'm gonna go here. You can exactly put the frame that you wanna be at. So I wanna be in the middle. Right now we have 90 frames and I wanna be on frame 45. On frame 45, I wanna have the cube twisted maybe at around 260 degrees so that we have the nice three portion of the colors that appears in a nice way. And I'm gonna keyframe that. And then as you see now, upla, at frame 45, it twists the angle like 260 degrees. But because I want this to loop, at frame 90, at the very end, I want it to go back to zero so that it's a full loop. So now, if I go back at zero and just play the animation, you can see that it loops. So right now, because we want a little bit more an interesting form and deformation, and so that the entire animation is a bit more dynamic, we're gonna make the cube turn onto itself. For this, I'm gonna use a null object. So a null object is pretty much gonna act to rotate the cube. So the cube is not gonna have to turn onto itself. It'll be parented with the null so that the null will actually be rotating, but the cube can just do the twisting. To make the null the parent of the cube, I'm just gonna drag the cube. And whenever I see the down arrow, I'm just gonna release my mouse and click on the null so that I can start animating it. So I'm gonna click on the rotation here on zero. And at the very end, I'm gonna do 90 and click up, enter 360, and then add the keyframe here once it's orange. So now I'm just gonna play back my animation. And as you can see, it's doing the 360 and the twisting at the same time. So now that I'm done with animating and the color is finalized, it's time to render our cube. So how we're gonna do that is that we're gonna click on the render settings over here, and just check that everything's in place. So I'm gonna click on output and just check our settings. So it's 1080 by 1080, resolution 72. That's good, the frame rate is 10. And the frame range, so usually the default setting is that it's set to current frame. So I just wanna go there and change it to all frames. So it's not just renders the first frame, but the entire animation. Then the format is TIFF, that's good. Everything looks good to me. So I'm just gonna close that window and just click on the play button here, which is gonna send the renders to our picture viewer. So there you can see our image is rendering and it should render quite fast. So we're done. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Please subscribe to the channel. And if you'd like to know more about me and my process, please check out my course at Domestika.